Aloha. You can call me Craw. I'm gonna mute this game because we don't need to hear what they're talking about. Aloha. You can call me Craw. Today we are playing Lego Star Wars 2, the original trilogy, the second of the Traveler's Tales Lego games. This is a unique title in many reasons. First and foremost being that it's one of the few games that has the numbers 1, 2, and 3 in the title. Original, 2, and Trilogy. So you don't get that very often. I feel this is really the moment where Lego games went from being a good idea to being a thing. You start to see a lot of the elements that become staples in other Lego games with this one. And it really is just kind of... I mean, the first Lego Star Wars was awesome. It was so much fun to play. But this one is where it really started to get zany. This is the point where the Lego universe starts to take its path to what it is today. This is, without this game, Lego Movie doesn't happen. Lego Movie 2 doesn't happen. A lot of the fun stuff you see doesn't really happen. Traveler's Tales took this concept, Lego games, and took it to the next level, and it all started here. I mean, if you think about it, between the time Lego Star Wars, the video game, came out and this one came out, Lego actually released another game called, of course my camcorder is frozen. I keep freezing it, properties. It's a little hairy right now. I need to stop putting my game controller and stuff there. Hold on. Let me get this going right. Properties. Cancel. Oh, man. Of course, this happens after you go live and you're comfortable in your chair and all that type of stuff. So let's put the controller down. Let's get this fixed on stream, shall we? Why'd I even look into the camera? Y'all can't see anything. My dad has a Saiyan, and I don't know how good the cam link is, the $200 cam link from Elgato. But I'm using a $20 knockoff link that I got off of Amazon. Right, so we're talking a tenth of the price that mostly does the job of what this is supposed to be doing. Mostly does the job of what it's supposed to be doing. But with anything, when you try to save money, you're gonna waste your time, right? I don't know how well the Cam Link works, because I don't have it. I'm not gonna spend $200 on that. I mean, I've got an Elgato capture card that's $150. Why would I buy a Cam Link unless I can't get to capture that? That's a different statement. Anyway, back to what we were talking about with the game. So yeah, this is really where Lego games took off. This is where they really started to get a lot of fun. So I'm very excited to play this. I hope you are just as excited to be here for tonight as I am. Let me make sure I put my phone in here to get charged. I definitely am excited about playing tonight because, again, this is such a classic game. I really do feel like this is an important game in history. And I have Para with a silent G in the house. Aloha, Para. I did not have my chat up, otherwise I would have said aloha to you earlier. Welcome to the stream. I hope you're going to enjoy the show. I'm going to enjoy the show. And now I realize I need to unmute the game so that we can get playing. That was the game audio. Oh, got it. There we go. It's rough. I really feel like I need a third monitor at this point. I need a monitor to play on, a monitor for my chat, and a monitor to see what's happening on OBS. Because right now, I'm basically saying I can only look at two things in the chat. All right, so let's get going. I'm playing, of course, on my original Xbox Duke controller. We're going to go to a new game. I literally have no points left. Para, you have been an MVP. Aloha the Bot is just kind of a jerk like that. You've been an MVP. I cannot appreciate how much you've donated to the Ready Player 2 challenge. I'll build them up over the course of the stream. Oh, yeah, of course you will. So here we go. Oh. So what I really like about this is, again, they get things started with a much better home base world than you have in the first LEGO video game. I feel like this just really screams all of what you're getting yourself into. I just really do think this is much better home world. Yeah, so let's get going. We're going to be doing story mode first, so we'll do story mode through episodes 4, 5, and 6, and we'll go back and do 3 play. We're trying to get to 100%. We'll see how much we do. You know, if I get to the point where I've completed all the levels, I have all the mini kits, I have all the stuff, and I'm, like, just buying characters, maybe I am not going to come back and go for that 100%. We'll see. We'll see how it falls. We'll see how long it takes me to do this, right? If I'm, like, in a month into this, may call it early, but we'll see. The plan is to go 100%. Episode 4, A New Hope. So how are you doing, Para? You have yourself a good day at school? I had a good day. I'm trying to make sure that I can at least see my my camera and my OBS, because again, I'm so paranoid about hitting my desk and making my cheap cam link not work that I feel like I need to be able to have an eye on what you guys are seeing every now and then. Right, like just now I moved my controller. Microscale build, but they just made it look like these massive bricks. Alright, here we go. Approach piles of Lego, press B and hold. So important to when you're first playing to do as much stud collection as you possibly can. Not that you're going for the 100% right now, but really, until you start getting those stud multiplier bonuses, it can be a chore to work your way through all of, towards your 100%, right? Until you start getting those stud multiplier, you are just like, because once you start getting them all, it's like, right now I already would have enough for True Jedi. That one first room, almost every single time, you get True Jedi. If you haven't already gotten it. Really enjoy this game. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, like, I am kind of excited, kind of annoyed that the third game, of course, is going to be Lego Star Wars the complete saga. So after I've worked my way all the way through the original game and then I walk myself through the second game, I have to work my way through both of them again with some slight modifications. Basically a second time before I get started doing any other things. You know, because Lego just didn't know what they were doing before now. Oh, that hurt. like they do a better job of... to the smoke, because once you get to the smoke, you can go back into the room, and now you're not going to have any stormtroopers chasing after you. Ooh. Of course, I'm going to need my good friend C-3PO to be able to unlock that. But again, this is what you have to do to grind to get to that 100%. Update the name of my stream, because there are some topics of things I do want to discuss, so I'm gonna update the name of my stream. I mean, don't get me wrong, I think it's a good name of a stream. I just feel like I got a better stuff. Where is my Twitch app? Sorry for pausing if I wanted to do this. There we go. Manager. Edit. No, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. Okay. Of course, this is not a true recreation of the Tantive IV bonus level from Star Wars, the video game. Hello, Sam. Aloha. How are you doing today? Oh, that's nice of Mom to say that.
Really? Why are you on your phone?
I just wanted to update my stream title. It's easier to do it from my phone than to do it from...
Wait.
Moving the stuff around.
Wait.
No. Sam. No. Let's not touch anything. Let's leave it exactly the way I have it.
This is an old level.
Well, no. Because now I'm playing LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy.
The one that I'm playing, that I used to play.
So there's five LEGO Star Wars video games, actually, believe it or not. There's LEGO Star Wars the video game. There's LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. There's LEGO Star Wars 3, which is based off of the Clone Wars, a television show. Then there's LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. I like how Princess Leia will dodge. She will dodge a bullet. Right, not many other characters with the blasters would do that. Let's get those quickly while we can. Should we get all this up? So anyway, then there's LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. And then there is the new game, which is going to come out in the spring, I believe. At least that's the rumor. And that's called LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga. And that's supposed to represent all 9 of the Star Wars movies. Of the quote-unquote Skywalker Saga, which is episodes 1-9. I don't know if they're going to be including some of the side stories, which I feel add equally to the universe and canon, and they're just as important. Like Rogue One, Solo. I think those are just as important for it to be in LEGO form. And so I hope that they're able to include them. We'll see if they do or not. Just get over here so we can get through the door. Then double back.
The fun fact part was the final.
What's the fun fact? True Jedi. Again, they name. This is the first time where they named what 100% of what the stud goal was called. Before it was just called the mini kit piece.
Should
Sam, let's not play with that. Let's just let it charge. Let it charge. What?
Let it go.
Yeah. I did base it on let it go. Okay, we can't shoot those. Good to know.
Why are you jumping?
I mean, I was maybe like sitting down, standing, so I wasn't gonna be able to hit them. But if you jump, everybody jump, jump. Jump. Please don't DMCA us over us singing very terribly. Crisscross, people. That's an homage. It shouldn't count. That would be great if I had that much money. He has $177. You honestly think that the person has the most money in the world?
Yeah. And wait, since the Nintendo Switch costs $300,
the $177 billion is probably more like what they have. $1 billion. You want to know who that guy is? I think his name is Jeff Bezos. Do you know what he owns?
A hot tub, a
panic. No, like what company he owns. Yes, I'm assuming Jeff Bezos has one, a hot tub, and two, a panic room. He may even have a hot tub inside of his panic room. If he doesn't, he needs to get on that ASAP. So, do you know what product that guy made? That's why he's so rich. It's something that gets arguably more important than 911.
What?
Nothing
more important than 911.
Nope.
The
nope. What usually comes literally every single day to our house?
The mail person.
Do we like anything that comes in the mail? No, he owns Amazon.
Amazon?
Now, we're going to go back here, because now that we have C-3PO, we can go back and open up a window.
Yay.
Well, it's not the end of the world for me to go back. Holy Todilo, thank you so much, Jorgen64PC. Welcome to the stream. Aloha, my friend. You can call me Craw. We are currently playing LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. This is part of my LEGO Star Wars, LEGO Traveler's Trails LEGO, replay. Yeah, that's what we're doing. I don't know if that helped anything. Welcome, I don't know if you're, I don't want to go all the way. That's way too far back. I didn't think I'd have to go that far back to use this guy to get into a room, but I guess I do, and I'm not, and that's not worth it for me. That's not worth it.
It's not worth it.
Not worth it.
Not worth it.
So, Jorgens, welcome to the stream.
Not worth it.
Yeah, I'm just gonna switch one of them because they are faster. And I feel like he will just be brought up to speed with me when I go into that next room.
Door. Is that the door?
Nope, that is. I need a stormtrooper to get through that door. Yes. So we did LEGO Star Wars the video game, and now we're on this one, and we're going to 100% all of the Traveler's Tales LEGO games in order Wednesday nights. And as long as it takes. So we're not going to be doing games like Lego Rock Band, because I consider that to be a Harmonix game and not a Traveler's Tales game. We're not going to do the Forza game, but if it is a Traveler's Tales Lego game, we're playing it 200%. That's the goal of what we do here. I've played most of the Lego games to 100% as it is, but there are some games I haven't. Like, I didn't play Lego Star Wars 3, the Clone Wars game, I didn't play that to 100%. I haven't played Lego Worlds, a couple of the new games I haven't done to 100%. One game I'm really excited to do, because I thought it was going to be a cheap knockoff, was I had played Lego Indiana Jones, the first one. And then I knew that they made a second one, and I just remember thinking to myself, why would I want to play this second game? Is it just literally one extra portion of the game, and from a movie I hated? Why am I going to play that, right? And so then I found out, no, they reimagined all of the levels. So I'm like, well, now it's kind of worth it to go play that. Then we can come over here. Stop moving. Oh, I guess I should jump out. Alright, let's go. Stop hitting that important person. So right now I'm definitely doing the stud collection grind, because I want to make sure that once I start getting this has the red bricks in it. I don't know. It's on the first level. But I'm thinking this does have the red bricks. I'm going to be able to get that stud multiplier. In my opinion, Lego Indiana Jones is really bad for a classic Lego game. Mediocre. You know what? You don't have to go far to convince me of that, my friend. I definitely feel like it looked like it was lacking, because again, I mean, the other one was such a good game. And then all they've done is added one extra world, in theory, to get you this thing. Alright, what do we got in here? Oh, I need to switch over to one of these people and have them go do it. But still, I've always wanted to play it. I've always wanted to try it out. And this is kind of a good excuse to have to do it.
Hey, Dad.
Yes. So those are the plans to the Death Star. So this is my son, Sam. Yep. He likes to crash the stream.
Sometimes.
Which again, it's a good strategy on his part if you ask me. So sometimes he crashes the stream and he asks me questions. He's learning about Star Wars. He has seen, in his lifetime, most of the Star Wars movies in terms of the original six. Like, he's watched them when he was like a little baby, and I just had him on in the background. He was just sitting there, you know, being a baby. Well, you were a baby. There's nothing wrong with being a baby. That's part of life. But at this point, you know, he's a mature adult. He doesn't really remember all of it. Yeah, and so there's a lot of things that he doesn't really remember about the Lego, the Star Wars universe, that him being able to watch them all in order, it's going to help give him that appreciation of the story and fill in some of those gaps. I just need to get through the smoke just so that it can reset this all. Okay. No, I don't need Iron Man though. So I do have to say, this is the one thing I miss about Princess Leia, is Princess Leia can dodge shot. You know, she will sit there and automatically dodge a shot. Lego Indiana Jones works like The Force Awakens. They're just kind of modern Lego games. Aren't as good as the originals, like Batman and Indiana Jones, Star Wars, and the Police. Yeah, no, I mean... Some Lego games I feel like I wouldn't even put Lego Batman with being one of the best Lego games. I remember playing it, I remember enjoying it, it just didn't jump out to me as being as good as, say, Lego Lord of the Rings. I really enjoyed Lego Lord of the Rings. You still love Lego Batman and Legos, all that stuff, but in terms of...
And you can just go back in time and find three old me and give him...
Sam, do you know what your first video game you ever played was? I think it was this or it was the complete saga. All you did was you made the guy jump and you thought it was the funniest thing in the world.
Come on, stop talking about my childhood.
Oh, sorry.
It's really... Just tell a baby story of me.
I don't think Jorgen's 64 PC is gonna like hold it against you for having a childhood.
Number one, I just destroyed Netflix.
Once it gets to this point, Lord of the Rings was decent, and Batman 2 later they just kind of lose its charm, still being a good game. Remember, this is, oh yeah, no, I mean, I recognize one, this is all everyone's opinion, right? We're all entitled to an opinion. I really like LEGO Lord of the Rings. And this is the selfish reason why I think I put LEGO Lord of the Rings up into the upper echelon of LEGO games, right? So I had seen...
What the? Why is he taking you back?
I had seen the original... Yes, no, I recognize the Frightening Underwear. I had seen Lord of the Rings. And I didn't think it was all that particularly good. And I was confused by most of Lord of the Rings. Lego Star Wars is your childhood. Cool. I had seen Lord of the Rings, right? And, like, it just was so confusing to me, the movies. I never read the books as a kid. And then I played the video game, because, again, Lego had built up enough... you know, respect for me that I was like, hey, even if this is a subject matter that I may not care for, I'm gonna at least try it. Because it's LEGO games. And I really liked that game. And then I went back and I watched the movie and I was like, holy Toledo. I don't know how LEGO Lord of the Rings made Lord of the Rings make more sense to me. And Lord of the Rings has become one of my favorite movie franchises. And it all started with LEGO Lord of the Rings. As weird as that sounds. And that's why I put it in the upper echelon, right? Like, I don't think there are many people who become a Batman fan because of LEGO Batman. I don't think people become a Star Wars fan because of LEGO Star Wars. I mean, maybe some people like Pirates of the Caribbean because they saw LEGO Pirates of the Caribbean and it was able to explain the source material that well. But LEGO Lord of the Rings did that for me, and that's one of the reasons why I put it in that upper echelon. I would say LEGO Star Wars, The Complete Saga, LEGO Dimensions, LEGO Lord of the Rings, those are the top notch in my mind. I can't think of any other ones that I just genuinely get excited about the idea that I'm going to play this game. Rebel Friend. C-3PO.
Why did you...
So I haven't made them yet, Sam. I'm literally just doing this for the first time. So, Jorgen 64 PC. I don't know if you remember this, but I haven't just played it. That's why you know this. But
oh yeah,
they don't call it True Jedi in LEGO Star Wars the video game. It's like mini kit something. It's a different name for what the 100%. It is. Mystery Kid or something like that. Let's do continue story, because we're just going to move onwards. LEGO Harry Potter was quite nice. Keeping the mumbling got me to watch the Sorcerer's Stone movie, causing me to end Harry Potter. So again, yeah, I would say that that's that same concept.
It's a really good Harry Potter
story. Yeah, so Sam loves the concept of Harry Potter, but when it actually comes down to actual Harry Potter, we've read the first book.
Dad keeps forgetting me to read.
We watched the first movie, we liked the first movie, but the first book, it was rough to get through, and we're in the second book now, and again, blames me for the fact that we haven't gotten through the second book. I'm not gonna go there, but, yeah, so I definitely do want, like, I'm hoping that by the time I get to the LEGO Harry Potter games, I'll at least have learned more about the Harry Potter universe, or it may just be exactly like you, where Keep Mumbling got me to watch. It got you more into Harry Potter because of the games. I'm hoping that's the case. Oh, I can press start now. Sorry.
Does that belong to a different Xbox?
Yes, this is the original Xbox controller. Let's play the newest one's called Xbox Series X. Or S. Xbox Series S. Or X.
Why is Luke Skywalker
hate C3PO? He doesn't hate C3PO.
And
those are called Jawas. Those little guys? They're called Jawas. Maybe who made them? They're like beings, they exist. Sorry, I love that so much. I just love that so much. That's one of my top five, like, Lego, like, pictures. I almost want to get that into a GIF or GIF. I never know what it's supposed to be called. And make that as, like, the raids, like, when someone raids me. Because it's just such a good little animation. I love Holy Toledo. We're never going to lose Holy Toledo. I don't know why you don't like Holy Toledo as much as I do.
Sometimes.
But I know why you don't like it as much. I grew up a fan of the Oakland A's, and the Oakland A's broadcaster is this guy named Roy Steele, and Roy Steele's catchphrase was, Holy Toledo. And so it's my way of honoring my childhood and my favorite baseball team. I'm not stealing his idea, I'm honoring his idea. The Lego games get you into Harry Potter. It covers all 8 films, all 7 books, excluding Curse of Child. I reckon not reading The Curse of Child, watching the play, since it breaks lore for most of them. Okay, that's good to know. Yeah, I don't know if I would get into the extended Harry Potter universe. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. Okay, good. I struggle just in main lore. Although, I have seen the Fantastic Beasts. I thought the first Fantastic Beasts movie was pretty good. And I thought the Lego Dimensions of the Fantastic Beasts was pretty good too. I feel like Lego Dimensions was such a missed opportunity. I mean, they gave it a good run, right? I feel like they did the best that they could. I just feel like it was such a missed opportunity for Traveler's Tales to just continue onwards. Because there's so many movies and so many things that they could have brought in to the Lego universe in a similar way that they brought Fantastic Beasts, the female Ghostbusters, and Lego Batman movie, which is to, you know, sell us a $30-$40 battle pack with some minifigures and have that be an extended portion of the game. Because that I do feel like there's a lot of stuff that they really just kind of tack on, right? Like, I felt like Lego Force Awakens was not worth the $60 or whatever it was MSRP. We bought it on sale because why not? But again, that could have been just an add-on to the Lego Dimensions universe for $30. Get me to get a minifigure and one of those base plates.
I remember what you could get in
the Lego set, and you had to open it. Yes, that's called the minifigure Lego sets.
I like those.
Yeah, they are pretty cool. Fantastic Beasts is better than Curse of Child, but not as good as everything else. Fantastic Beasts is still really good, though. I agree, Dimensions had a lot of wasted potential. And again, I think it just comes down to, I think the biggest waste for Dimensions was that they didn't go all into it, but they were developing other games in conjunction with it. If you took all of the Marvel stuff, all of the things, they said every game going forward is going to be LEGO Dimensions add-on, it would have worked. I honestly think it would have. But it was asking too much of people to say, hey, do this and this and this and this. It just was too much.
I think Ghostbusters
was
really popular.
And also, I think one of the biggest problems with Season 2, and again, I recognize it's Warner Brothers. Warner Brothers babies, and they pumped it full of Warner Brothers IPs. I 100% get that. But, did we really need a Knight Rider? A Knight Rider level? Did we need that? We did not need that. I mean, I'm a child of the 80s. I recognize nostalgia is a nostalgia state. But I just feel like too often times they take stuff and they say, this is nostalgia, when it really isn't nostalgia, right? Knight Rider was not that big of a show back then, right? It became bigger of a show. Oh, got me. Gotta get the studs. I'm not doing good stud-wise right now, by the way. I think this is a super long level. But yeah, and I think, so when I think about really the flaw with LEGO Dimensions, is Season 1, I feel, was excellent. I feel Season 2 just becomes this slog through forced nostalgia of things that really, when people think about what made the 80s great, these are things that people think. These were not the big things of the 80s.
Hey, are you confused with some of the names of the Outer Worlds? Because I can tell you something.
Okay.
I've just been singing about the final show. And I even know how to make, if you're wondering, Sam, how do we send a message? Just hit the gnome or the gnome at the big thing that looks like the Eiffel Tower.
Got it.
Or if you're wondering, Sam, how do you cook the gnome? Guess what? It's pretty simple. There's a controller in the first room, then there's a TV in the last room. You just have to bring the controller back. The TV is in the room. And if you're wondering, Sam, how do you make pets out? You just put every single guy in one house. Just all the animals in one house. Nothing else you need.
Nothing else.
And some of the rewards are pretty easy to make. Like,
I don't know why that guy's not shooting at me right now.
Yeah, that's weird.
That's weird that he's just kind of chilling there.
Or like,
I think I really knocked him off, and now they don't know what to do with him.
I think if you go on Netflix and you see the show called Horror's Law, but it is not horror.
No, I don't think it is horror. It's a kid action show.
It's not. It's not like, dying! What? And someone tries to.
What I always really enjoy, and I don't think about it until I'm hearing the music, but so much of episode 4 soundtrack. Oh man, I can't push that backwards. I'll swing it from back here and get those pieces. Sounds like Planet of the Apes to me. It just feels like it's the Planet of the Apes soundtrack.
I think.
And I don't blame the Planet of the Apes soundtrack is one of the best musical soundtracks there is. But just this part right here. Like, you cannot convince me that this is not LEGO Planet of the Apes right now. Oh, excellent.
So, maybe you could just think of what an item might do to hit something that an item might do. Like, for example, from the message code. It just. What? Wait!
Don't care. We need to get rid of them. Jawas are evil.
Are they like Darth Vader?
No, they're not like Darth Vader, but, you know.
Wow, why do they want to build a robot?
I would say that's the biggest change I think between Lego Star Wars and Lego Star Wars 2 was I feel like in Lego Star Wars the games are the levels are reasonable length, and I would say that's also one of the biggest problems the Lego has been facing. Its levels have gotten so long. I feel like I've played like 8 levels already from Lego Star Wars. That's how long this is.
I need to get my stretching off.
There you go. Yeah, probably. Well, no, the next Friday after that is Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
We'll see. Or maybe we'll play Jackbox. There's so many things to choose.
Yeah, I love Jackbox. I like Christmas and Jackbox. And I don't know which one's better. But I'm so far saying Among Us. So and on the first round, I thought you could put two eyes in. First, I put French fries in. Then I thought you could make two eyes. Then I accidentally put my name on at the end.
Yes.
Come
on, maybe Jackbox might want you to edit your
Can he just
make it? Can the Jackbox make it easier for gamers?
Yeah, but now since after that level,
I think that's not what I wanted to do. Yeah, so I did enjoy the Fantastic Beasts, the first one. I started to watch the second one. I think it's still on HBO Max. But I fell asleep when I was watching, and I kind of have a strict rule that if I fall asleep watching a movie and I'm not like exhausted, tired, it's not that good of a movie, and I'm not really gonna invest the time to go back and watch it the second time, which is why I haven't gone back and watched.
You can just go up there.
I haven't gone back and rewatched the second Fantastic Beasts movie. Also, I'm not that big of a Johnny Depp fan, honestly. I'm not trying to talk bad to people who are Johnny Depp fans. I'm not trying to get into any wars with fandoms here. I just don't think that. People like different things, and it's okay to like different things.
Yeah, just like
one of his favorite TV shows. Which one of Audrey's favorite TV shows? Audrey being, of course, the man of Jorg and...
Oh, wait, I want to tell something. If you want me or Audrey to go, if you want me to go, donate to the community church ready.
Oh, wait, I do have a guy who can... I was like not doing any of this because I didn't think I had a force user. I feel like really like I wasn't thinking. Ben Kenobi is Obi Wan Kenobi. This was a nickname that they gave him. He gave himself to like make himself be a little more incognito, right? So guys are like, oh, we want to find Obi Wan Kenobi, and they're looking for Obi Wan Kenobi in the phone book. And like, well, we don't know who this Ben Kenobi is, but it's not Obi Wan, obviously. So that's why he went by Ben Kenobi. So people would think he isn't Obi-Wan. Which, of course, he immediately gives it up as soon as Luke Skywalker asks. But that's not a plot point I'm really willing to fight with Star Wars fans over. There's a lot of problems that need to be discussed about the Star Wars universe.
Where the heck are those,
It's not that they're putting them in cages.
Why are they doing that?
No, it's just they sell the robots, and rather than have the robots get up and walk around. Yeah, exactly. You got to keep the robots still. First mini kit piece. It's always exciting to get a mini kit piece. Are you changing the colors on the sand? Did I not turn off my... I don't think I turned off my, from earlier today. Hold on. I still have my filter on. My translucency, hold on, let me get rid of that. My bad. Filters. Yeah, I still have my chroma key on. That was not intentional. I apologize.
It's quicker. It's going quicker, Dad. Boop, 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 boop. This is the thing that changes the lights. You can make a reward for them to pick what color your lights can be. That'll be a good reward.
Really? People would want to do that? I don't know, Jorgen, you let me know. Would that be a reward that you would want?
Yeah.
To be able to change what color my lights off screen are.
Yep.
I won't judge you if you say you want that. I'm just curious.
Yep. And you should tell them, and I should make up every single reward to make it even more thing. And I'm thinking of making a community challenge. Ooh, what about this? To make a community challenge to let Maggie be in front of the camera the whole entire time.
Maggie would not want to be on camera. For the benefit of your audience, Maggie is our
dog.
Aloha, yay! Old fat guy. Welcome to the stream. Ladies and gentlemen, if you do not know Old Fat Guy, let me do some introductions around.
I'll do some introductions.
Let me do the introductions. It's my stream. It's my stream. Old Fat Guy is a mental health advocate. His streams generally are going to involve, talking about mental health challenges, and he plays some video games while doing it. Overall, solid dude. Today, we have met Jorgen64PC. I know next to nothing about Jorgen. So, Jorgen, if you'd like to tell us, do you stream? And if so, what types of games do you stream? Because I'd like to be able to introduce you properly when we do have other people in the chat join us.
And I am Sam, who's co-hosting the stream.
You are not co-hosting the stream. You are just sitting here until it's time for you to go to bed, mister. I'm just trying to be honest with you. Oh yeah, Paro the Silent G was in the chat earlier, but I think he had to go off and lurk in something. Para is, of course, a rock star follower, one of the best of the best.
Yep.
If you're a streamer and you can get someone like Paro the Silent G in your stream, your life just becomes better.
Yeah, Paro and him are all time.
Sam recently learned that fun fact that Luke Skywalker and Princess Leia are twins.
Yep.
He did not know that.
And I knew it. I just looked it up on my phone book.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah. Okay, can everybody call me the,
People will contribute if they want to contribute, Sam. You can't be, like, trying to get people to contribute.
Wait, yeah, I just have to stop.
Yep, all you gotta do is stop.
Whoa, that was quick. You would die if you do that. In real life.
That bad? He's a Jawa. Yeah, I think Jawas are bad. Yeah, look, he's gonna go down. R2. Yeah, run, run, Jawa. Get rid of all the Jawas. I mean, I know that Obi Wan Kenobi is like an old Jedi. I get that. But I honestly think he's the worst Jedi to play with. He just is. I don't feel he's very, like, good at things. I just do think he's the worst Jedi to play with. I mean, no other Jedi or Sith person is as good as Darth Maul in Lego Star Wars the First. He's just phenomenal to use. It does look awesome. It's an American word. Because destroying droids is fun. Why you gotta do that to me, Sam? Oh, there's nothing else in there. Sam, stop that, please.
Okay,
63. Yep, we're moving up there in the world, Sam.
Yep.
Nope, you're not typing. Paro the Silent G contributed some more because they earned some more. Excellent job, Paro the Silent G.
Why is this not 63?
Because they contributed some. That's the grand total of all the points that Paro has contributed overall. So when you think about the 63,000 points we redeemed, Paro has redeemed 27,000 of it. So Paro has donated almost half of it. Half of that is Paro's job.
Oh, let me see. Paro's the Silent G. All your points you have donated. I got 47 yesterday.
See, like right there. He got shot by a Tusken Raider. Right. If I felt like my Darth Maul would have cut that Tusken Raider down.
1 second, I
want
to do the math now. Okay. Sorry. Right. 72,000 and something.
I just feel Obi Wan is not as good of a.
If we had a challenge, who donated the most, you would be top.
Yeah, no questions asked. Paro would be the winner of that. No, so actually, it's a good question for Paro. Hara, Sam has suggested one of the things I need to add to the stream is a channel point redemption where you can change my accent color.
Yep, like this. Like this. Like this. And I'll be the one to do it. You just have to show my name and then I'll come around.
Well, I think generally the streamers who do that type of challenge or that functionality, what they've done is they have, they automate it, right? So the person donates the money, and then it automatically just changes it, and no one has to do anything.
What the?
Yeah, like I'm watching. No. No. They build these things called macros, and the macros do it automatically. So, like, for instance, today when I was in, stop looking at my phone, please. Let me finish explaining what this is. So, like, for instance, today I was in my friend Ninji's stream, Ninji Sojo. If you are looking for a woman from New York who is obsessed with Just Dance and Japanese culture as a whole, Ninji Sojo is for you. So she had, for instance, you know, she's got a V of lights behind her, right, that do things. And you can, like, do a hashtag, and it'll change the color schemes and other stuff. It's an awesome stuff. It's the type of stuff that I feel some viewers really love that type of stuff. They just find that so cool to be able to do that. I was talking right to my death.
Talking right to your death. I remember that.
Ghostbusters?
Yeah.
That actually came out in the 80s, Sam. Yeah. Theodore Roosevelt was not president in the 80s. He was president in the 1910s. President in the 80s was mostly a guy named Ronald Reagan.
Oh, Ronald Reagan. When they started to have
color. When they started to have what?
Color. So, like, George Washington had color.
Oh, like a color photo.
That doesn't make any sense. That looked like 19s. That was 19s. The gray color photo.
Alright, let's put these back and let's reverse the order of what we just put on here. I think that's my problem.
What? No, that doesn't make any sense.
It makes a lot of sense, Sam. Look.
Well, if that was a If that was a snowman, that would not make sense.
Yes, well, this isn't a snowman, Sam. This is Lego Star Wars.
Well, Lego only works.
Maybe they just up the difficulty so much more on this game. But again, I feel like I die so much more frequently. Does look like my father's thing, yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
Oh, well.
Yes, and yes, Par, it is always important to donate your 90 points to the challenge.
No, you mean
72
points.
Well, he just donated 90 points. That's why he said it's important to donate the 92 points.
No, and I literally did the math. And 27 plus 45. People 72. I did that literally with my math. I just carried the one to the 10th place. And I just added the
10th. That is second grade math. Second grade math, eh? Anyway, Sam, you've been here for a while. Can you say aloha to the chat so you can go do the rest of your evening stuff? You can even watch the chat if you do not comment, which you don't mean to comment. I know you so well.
No, baby. Yeah, I just like to.
Yes, well, Sam, I would like it if you said aloha to the chat and moved on for the evening.
Aloha!
Thank you, Sam. Ladies and gentlemen, my son, Sam. I recognize that. I'm giving you credit. Don't get me wrong. I love my children, both of them. They're very special. There's just a point where I'm like, all right, we're done. We're done. I'd like to think that when coronavirus is over and I don't have to be the teacher in addition to being dad, it would take a lot longer for me to get to that. Oh, that was close. I think I can make it though. Look at that. I'll have a little more patience with it. I just think right now. It is so rough. One of my few times I get some relaxation away from being a dad with kids is this. Alright, I had you here for a while. This is the level that just never ends, and I feel this way with so many of the Lego Star Wars. Again, it's not meant to be a criticism, but it is a great game. It is so much fun to play, but and I think that's one of the problems I have with a lot of Lego video games. The levels just go on and on and on, and people don't have the patience. Keep playing, which is again why they introduce mid-game, mid-level saves, right? At this point, I don't think this is mid-level saves. But they do introduce that later. Alright, we're almost at the end of the level. Look, I have no hope that I'm gonna be able to play all of episode 4 tonight. Whereas I was able to do all of episode 1 in one night, all of episode 2 in one night, all of episode 3 in one night. I was even able to get some of my bonus levels in those one nights, you know what I mean? And my nights, in my streaming nights, are roughly about 2 hours. That's kind of like the line I draw in the sand. It's 2 hours, like I'm emotionally done streaming at that point. Aloha, Geeky Girl Games. Welcome to the chat. Ladies and gentlemen, if you do not know one of my fabulous mods, you're lucky because she's here in the chat. She's the one, the only Geeky Girl Games. She mostly does Sims, but I know she aspires to be a variety streamer playing other games beside The Sims, but she mostly plays The Sims, and she's phenomenal at it. I don't play The Sims myself, but I will watch her every time I have an opportunity to watch her play The Sims. Well, just fell apart. How are you doing today? How was school? For the benefit of everyone, Geeky Girl is a teacher from Montana, and so it's always good to show her and appreciate all that she's doing in this hard time with coronavirus, because it ain't easy being a teacher. Well, it's just true. It ain't easy being a teacher. Because there are very few games that, like, I don't play that I'm willing to watch, right? Like, I tend to watch games that I play, but the one game that I don't watch that I will play is The Sims, and it has to be specific people who I know and I think are good at it, and I enjoy the stream. And Geek Girl, you are one of those people. No questions asked. Yeah, so they've re-logged down here from a coronavirus perspective. So we are dealing with that. And then also on top of that, to make matters worse, with the snowstorm of the century, which is coming this week, we have these snowstorms that are called nor'easters here. You may not have heard of them, not living in New England, geeky girl. When I first moved here, I lived in a bar, and I was talking to a guy from Oregon about Oregon. Kids' behavior is just dwindling more each day. About the nor'easter, I said, "What's it like? Is it all it's cracked up to be?" He's like, "You know, we have a word for nor'easters in Oregon." I'm like, "Really? What are they?" He goes, "It's called snow." And I will never get that out of my head. The dude from Oregon is like, "Yeah, it's just snow. It's all it is. It's nothing they cracked up to be like they make it out to be." So yeah, we have a big nor'easter coming in tomorrow, and they, as of like 2 o'clock this afternoon, they actually had announced in advance that schools would be closed tomorrow. And I'm like, and the reason being is they're fearful that there's gonna be a lot of disruptions with power and other things, and so just call it off now. And I'm like, come on, there's no legitimate reason aside from the mental health, and that's very legitimate. So let me take that back. The mental health of all the people involved is the only valid reason that I'm willing to have a snow day right now. That they're saying we need to give our teachers that mental health day. And if they flat out came out and said that, I would support the snow day. If they're going to hide behind this idea that we need a snow day because it's going to be snowing and kids aren't going to have time to get out of bed and get into school remotely in time. No, I'm not buying that this year. I'm not buying that going forward anyway, right? This is the new reality. Kids are going to be able to be remote learn at all times going forward. Not saying they have to do it at all times, I'm just saying. Snow days, in my mind, are a relic. Relic of the past. You love snow days? Well, I think because I didn't grow up having snow days, there is like zero nostalgia for me to have it. I view snow days as a day where I'm working and my kids are home and I have to deal with them. And I don't even have the benefit of being able to send them outside and, like, just go play in the backyard for a couple hours. Or send them to summer camp or anything. So, yeah. Snow days. Not where I'm at mentally. I'm not mentally ready for them. It's disappointing because I was talking to the superintendent back in September. And I was like, And I was like, snow days are a thing of the past, right? You're never going to have snow days anymore, right? And he's like, yeah. And here we are. And he actually said, like, 2 days ago, sent out an email to the whole district. Like, don't worry. This is what we're going to do. And then, like, today, he's like, nope, snow day tomorrow. I'm like, oh, come on. Killing me. Now, of course, in Montana, they're incredibly rare because we can get schools in ridiculous conditions. Do not discount that, geeky girl. I do not discount how ridiculous it can be there. Yeah. I really enjoy when people are like, when I was a kid, we went to school this type of weather. And the kids these days are so soft, they can go to school. We had These are all the times I did not have school on a regularly scheduled school day growing up. When I was in the first grade, there was a teacher strike that lasted for 3 months or something like that. Maybe it was 2 months. And there were a couple days initially where they didn't have a plan. The school district and the school didn't have a plan and we didn't have school. When I was in the fifth grade, we had an earthquake, a 6.9 earthquake that rocked the San Francisco Bay Area, and we were out of school for a week while they seismically inspected all the properties to make sure that it was safe for us to actually physically be in the building, considering my elementary school was built on bedrock in the 20s. We all knew it was going to be safe. We all knew. But we enjoyed the week off. And then when I was in high school, I think my junior year, there was another teacher strike. So those are the three times I missed school. I never had snow days. I had an earthquake day. That's always fun. Oh. This is another one great level to go through. But again, how incredibly long these Lego Star Wars levels are. I had a professor in Chicago that said, I live across the street. I don't care how much snow we get. I'll climb my ass over any snow pile being class. I expect you to do the same. Then the 2011 blizzard hit. Cars were literally abandoned on Lakeshore Drive and the power's out. I bet that bastard went to work. It was kind of funny. So when I first moved here, that was 12 years ago. And I worked for a company that, I'm not going to say prided itself, but there definitely were employees who prided themselves on the idea that there were snow days, right? These people have been with the company for 30 years, and they're like, oh, the only time they closed the building was because there was a fire in the cafeteria. They had all these reasons why the company had this fire. But by the time I stopped working there, working from home had become such a thing. Nothing devastated. Such common practice. It was like, oh yeah, we're going to get snow tomorrow, or we get snow on Monday, guys, so let's all work from home on Monday. And they tell us that on Friday. And now I work for a company that is so work from home friendly, it's like they don't even like question that you go work from home. Right? I've never once felt where I'm at that I can't work from home because of work. And it's an amazing feeling. Be with a company like that. Again, just in the past 12 years, that's how far it's come. That's when I think about that old school mentality that I'm going to come into work no matter what and all that time. And, I just think it's an unhealthy mindset to have. Right, I mean, it's Cal Ripken disease. Everyone wants to be Cal Ripken. He never misses a day in 17 years of playing baseball. Steroids. But it's just not healthy in the long run. There's so much adverse effects that can happen to people and things if you don't take the necessary precautions when you're sick and stuff, right? So, I mean, again, I'm not trying to badmouth Cal Ripken because I do recognize a lot of people as a hero. But despite the fact he played in, 2,131 consecutive games, never missed his game, his team went to the World Series and won the World Series how many times in that time period? Maybe you should have taken a day off here and there. Just saying. Right? I mean, I know that not every team gets to win the World Series, and Kayla, being a person who's from Chicago, probably can relate to that as a Chicago Cubs and or White Sox fan. Now, mind you, they both have won the World Series relatively recently, so it's not as much of a burn as it used to be to say something like that. Right, that used to be a very sore subject for them. You're a Cubbies fan. I didn't know if you were a Cubs or White Sox fan. I know you're a Blackhawks fan, but I don't know, like, right, like, so being in the Bay Area from where I'm from, right, if you're an A's fan, you may be a Raiders fan. If you're a Giants fan, you're most likely guaranteed also going to be a Niners fan, right? I don't know if alliances are that strong, like the Cubs and the other, right? Like, if you're a Cubs fan, you're going to be a fan. Although, Chicago only has... I'm used to disappointing here, Cubs fan. Well, that's a good thing to tell people, I guess. Right, Chicago only has two baseball teams. They don't have, like, two football teams. They don't have two basketball teams. They don't have two hockey teams. It's just two baseball, right? So I think it's just Los Angeles, the Bay Area, and... oh, man, there's so many. New York that has multiple sports teams and multiple different... Get the Sox. Yeah, maybe there isn't the best app. I gotta hide over here to do this. See, now I can go up there. Once I go up there, they're not gonna be able to come out through that door. Right, now they're not gonna be able to regenerate. Need to do to get rid of these fools. Forget the Sox. Well, isn't Tony Russo going back to manage the Sox? I mean, I think that's a great idea. You know, he worked out so good for the last time he was with the Sox. Right, he's obviously still managing routinely, so obviously he's at the top of his game. Everyone from the south side of Chicago a White Sox fan, and the north side a Cubs fan. Like, is that pretty, like, standard issue about Chicago sports? I mean, these are legitimate questions I don't know the answer to. Most of them, but I'm the unicorn from the south side who's a Cubs fan. I appreciate that you're a unicorn. Oh, yeah, I remember how to get that. Tell people it's due to the fact that my father has a master's, so we're classy educated people. We're Sox fans, not classy educated people. I don't know my rules about what stereotypes there are for fans. Right, like, 'cause that is definitely a perception between the difference between Raider fans and Niner fans. The Niner fans are classier, and Raider fans are scum of the earth. And I say that proudly as a Raider fan. Not saying that as someone who's trying to talk bad about the Raiders. I'm actually very happy that the Raiders moved to Las Vegas and now get to have them in the media market for the first time. The rivalry is strong. Yeah, rivalries tend to be strong. South side is supposed to be the sketchy side, north side is for the rich people. Yeah. So you guys were rich. So, again, I'm not trying to get too personal. Were you guys rich for the south side or poor for the north side? Right? That's an important distinction to know, right? I definitely would say, like, our family is the name of our town poor. I mean, one, we're in a very rich, snotty town in the first place, but, you know, we don't have a Tesla. We have a Chevy. It's not a car. My dad's a preacher, so we're, What denomination, if you don't mind me asking? I mean, you said preacher, so one, I know it's not Catholic. Two, the fact that your dad tells me it's not Catholic. Right. And I don't think there are too many Catholic fathers who happen to be fathers. That's the right terminology for it. He's Presbyterian. Oh, very nice. Let's go back here. Got him. Presbyterian. Now, here's a question, and I do know that some people do it, but when you got married, did your dad perform the ceremony? Cute if he did. I'm not going to be mad if he didn't. I'm just saying. I know a lot of people do that. Can I get through here? Nope, I can't get through there. At least not right now. Walked down the aisle and did the ceremony. Oh, it's super cute! I mean, I don't know too many daughters of preachers, or sons of preachers for that matter. I've just always been curious if that's like part of the like deal, right? Like if your parent is a preacher, you just assume that they would be doing your wedding someday? Or like how much of a scandal would it have been in your home congregation had he not? You did your premarital counsel with someone else. Don't blame you. We were married in the Catholic Church. My wife was Catholic at the time. I think she still might identify as Catholic, but last time her Catholic Church was Audrey's Baptist. Just to give you a clue how long it's been. Which I'm Methodist, I was born nothing. Raised Methodist, after my brother went to a vacation Bible camp as a kid and came back and asked our parents, what is God? And my parents were not really prepared to answer that question. So, his priest school happened to be at a Methodist church, and they just said, you know what? He really likes going to this preschool. Let's go to the church, too, because the Sunday school teachers are his preschool teachers. Funny how that works out. I swear, Methodists were slightly evil that way. Dad was baptized ever in our family, including Mama. I had, when I was a baby, what is known as a dedication ceremony, aka my parents are hippies, and they wanted a baptism, but they didn't want to go with the whole, let's actually make sure that our child has salvation. We're just gonna say, let's have a party where a wise person can come over and say wise words and about this baby that's been born. And hopefully this will do something spiritual. That's what my parents had for me when I was a kid. I'm not saying my parents are terrible people. I'm just saying that is that's how we roll. Yeah, so that was the last time. So we got married in the Catholic Church. We went to pre-Cana, which is like one day. I hear, depending on your congregation, it would be a very long ordeal. But for us, it was one day. Yeah. So I'm with you entirely in that I want my kids to be able to have the faith that is their faith, not my faith that I've put onto them. That being said, I don't feel I'm really doing my part unless I introduce them to what my faith is, and that I give them the tools to kind of help find that exploration themselves, right? So, you know, we're active in the church. The kids go to the church. Again, this is a sneaky Methodist. It was their nursery school. And again, we were, you know, we were doing church shopping. We were looking at all the different places we could go. And it just so happened that the place where we were sending the nursery school just worked out good that they had one. They didn't have nearly as good integration as the school that I went to as a kid did. But in terms of having the Sunday school teachers actually be the preschool teachers, too. That's that next level vertical integration. But yeah, I mean, nothing would make me happier than for my kids to find the salvation and faith that worked for them that has nothing to do with mine, because I know at that point they truly have picked the one that they want to be a part of and not just doing what I want them to do. Right? They're not just following my path. I mean, I have my beliefs and I hope that they will also have my beliefs. Alright, cool. Now, we're not going to go blow that up, because I want to come back to that. I want to go over to here to what I feel is a massive hole in the Star Wars canon, which is that we don't know where, right? We don't know where Luke Skywalker sells his land speeder. We know that he sells it. We just don't know where he did it, right? Is it Crazy Al's land speeder Emporium? This is the answer, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, for me, it was always important that we raise our kids in, and I said this one, right? I don't care what church we raise them in, as long as we raise them in a church. So, a community, and that's just what we have. I mean, it's a phenomenal community we have with the kids and all that stuff, and just as a whole, really is the right church for us to be raising our kids in, so. Now I've sold it. Isn't that just awesome now? Don't you feel like you know more about the Star Wars universe, having seen the actual sale of the land speeder? I can't remember the double score zone being in too many other games. I feel like this is the one of the few games of the LEGO games where they have double score zones. I could be wrong. I mean, we'll find out as we play through them. But I feel like this is it. I feel like this is the one. Made him pop out. Haha! I got up here too. Then I Well, in high school, because I decided that if I wanted to be baptized again, he wouldn't do it because he was already baptized as an infant. Yeah. So the only loophole, again, I think maybe every church does it differently, but my brother was baptized in the Methodist church as like a 13-year-old, and then as an adult in the Catholic church in Berlin. Because, the Catholic church is very staunch about their baptism. They're this, they're that. I remember when we got married, they wanted like proof that I had been baptized. And so I had to call my church. I was like, yeah, I need some document that says I've been baptized. And they're like, okay. And they have like this ledger, right? Like a freaking, right? Like bank transactions. It was just a list of baby, the person, the time, who the godparents were. And that was like it. It was like nothing else. It was like nothing official. And I just remember them like getting me a photocopy of the page that was when I was baptized. And having to like take it to the Catholic Church. Like, this is what we have. And I could just sense the like disappointment in their face. When they're like, that's what we have. Like, yeah, then this is what we have. I'm sorry. Right. Because I mean, I've seen my wife's baptism certificate. And this is an impressive-looking document. I would argue that it is a prettier, nicer document than our marriage certificate. It's a work of art compared to my photocopy ledger. Yeah, and all baptisms are equal, right? But if you were to assign a value to a baptism that looks more impressive on paper. And I literally do mean on paper in this instance. Because, you know, it's the paper that looks better. Also, I went to, like, a super hippie church growing up. They actually had a moat around, like, they have these huge windows on one wall that overlooks the lake. And then there's a moat along the front of the lake. And so for the baptism, the people, like, take the cup and go over and scoop up the water from the moat next to the windows. Sure, the water in the moat came from the tap. I don't think that there's some holy water sitting in the Lake Mary United Methodist Church in Oakland, California. Bowls and tap water. Do you know what I thought was so interesting? And I found this out, you know, from my current congregation. I have no idea what other congregations do. But the leftover wine or grape juice, more accurate for Methodists, from communion that isn't served, they go into the woods behind the church and they pour it out. And I always just thought, like, when I heard that, I instantly thought of, like, pouring one out for Jesus Christ, pouring one out for your homies. I don't know if you appreciate the humor in that or not, geek girl. Please let me know if it offended you. It would hurt if I did. Because I generally do think that is hilarious. This is one of my favorite sublevels. And shoot up the cantina. And then you shoot all the like people who are mad that you killed one of their friends. That's great. I'm sure they use the same bottle of Walter's grape juice until it's gone. No, I'm. So here's what. So, I think what it is, you have the cups, right? And then they pour from the Welch's grape juice into the cup, right? Okay, are you following me with that? And then you take your bread and you dip it in the cup and you put that in, right? And now that cup of juice is contaminated with the bread, right? So they can't just reuse that, right? They would have to strain it and then boil it, and then that probably ferments it and then pour it back in the Welch's bottle. So I think that they don't take the rest of the bottle and pour it out. They just take what's in the cup, which has the bread and the germs and the mucus from the people, and they pour that. Oh, we keep our watches and Wonder Bread separate. Ooh, Wonder Bread. I'll say that's one of the biggest, like, letdowns of being raised in the Bay Area and, like, moving to, like, not the Bay Area, San Francisco Bay Area, is, we had, when I was growing up, communion was with sourdough bread. Like, they had just a massive sourdough round, and they, like, they tore little chunks off of it, and it was delicious, and, like, you would get communion, be excited about communion, because it was good bread, and there was good Welch's, and you're like, this is solid, I'm gonna enjoy this. And now it's like, especially with coronavirus, we have these little cups. I don't know if I posted it on Instagram. I don't know if I did or not. But it's like this little Catholic waiver thing in like this little shot glass. So it's like a little shot glass, like a Jello shot, but it's not Jello. And then there's like a thin little plastic layer, and then there's a Catholic wafer that's like cardboard, but you put it in your mouth, and then you pour the shot of Welch's in, and then that dissolves in your mouth, so it's like two layers of stuff. Aloha, the Lone Wolf 007. Welcome to the stream, my friend. My name is Craw, and we are currently making jokes because that's how we roll here. So one, if you're offended by religious jokes, I'm going to apologize up front, but we are kind of having a discussion about that, but having fun in all seriousness. I'm well. I'm having a good day today. I'm playing Lego Star Wars 2, the original trilogy, and this is a lot of fun as a game, so this is good. You know me. I know you? Oh, wait, I haven't been here since the name change. Yes, probably not. I feel bad. What was your old name, the Lone Wolf? I'm very curious. Pumpkin Panda! Welcome, Pumpkin Panda! Oh, see, now I know who you are. Tingling. I know you. Yes, it was very awkward for me. Geeky girl. I felt like literally the worst person in the world. I didn't know this person who obviously knows me and obviously wants to be here. And I'm like, who are you? You know what it was? This is what it reminded me of. So my mom was a politician when I was little. And she's a politician now, still to this day. But there were so many times we would be out like grocery shopping or something, and people just knew her. That was just part of her existence, that everywhere we went, there was people there. They wanted to talk to her about what was going on and what she was doing about it. And just one of these things that I'm so used to my entire life, people like knowing me and my mom, and I have no idea who any of these people are. No idea who any of these people are. So I always generally feel bad when someone's like, I know you, and I'm like, I have no idea who you are. So thank you so much for letting me know who you are, and I do know who you are. You're not just some random person who I don't recall. Feel free to continue calling Pumpkin or Panda. I'm going to be happy every way. I don't know. Do you change your name to Lone Wolf for a reason? I want to know what you prefer to be called, because I do think that there is nothing better than the sound of your own name. and I want to respect your choice and your decision to stop being a panda and start becoming a wolf. I do have to say, this game is a lot easier once you have Han Solo to shoot with. He definitely will tear through a bunch of stuff quicker. Yeah. I like being called geeky. Okay, I will make sure I make a conscious effort, geeky, of calling you geeky. I know that I always call you geeky. That's one of, I would say, one of my weaknesses as a person. I tend to default to very formal names. Once I know a formal name, right? Like, if I know your name is Penelope, and you prefer Penny, I have a really hard time calling you Penny. That's just one of my weaknesses, and it's something that I'm always trying to do a better job of. Alright, even if I never knew you as a Penelope, the second I find out, nope, your full name is Penelope, it's over. I'm never gonna call you anything else. And it's not that I'm, like, consciously trying to be a jerk, it's just that's kind of how my family rolls, right? Like, my brother, he's got, 4 kids. All Saint names, of course, because he's a good Catholic. And, all of them have long formal names. Similar to like Sam, right? Sam is long for short for Samuel. So my nephews are Gregory, Andrew, Peter, and my niece is Teresa. And they're all Gregory, Andrew, Peter, and Teresa. Not Greg or Greggy, not Andrew or Andy, not Pete. Well, Pete isn't even that much shorter than Peter. I don't even know what, like, Teresa isn't Terry, she's Teresa. Just how my family rolls, right? My mom is always Kathleen, and my dad is always Thomas, and my brother's Ken. He is short for Kenneth, but, I just tend to be very formal with names. I mean, I've got a name that doesn't really commonly get shortened. Some people shorten it, and I always think it's great when people shorten it because I just find it so fascinating that people watching a certain demographic all call me the exact same short name. It's almost like they have like a meeting somewhere. And I'm like, okay, guys, we're gonna call all people with this name the same shortened name. No one's ever explained to me how that is. Wolf, if you like. I don't mind, though. I know a few still call me Pumpkin Panda. It's a nice nod back to my name, so I like it. Wouldn't want to be forgotten since it annoyed me so much that I have to have an underscore in it. Yeah, no, I hear you on that. Oop. Can I turn the game volume down to north? Sure, of course. Thank you for letting me know that was going a little off. All right, let's go game. Let's take that down to 8. And we're going to take my volume from -7 to -5. How's that? It's hard to hear me during a battle. Okay, cool. Yeah, you have a nice voice. Let's hear it clear. Well, it would be even better if I had a microphone that was close to my mouth. I was actually watching a girl who is a YouTube streamer. She doesn't stream live. She just records herself playing the game and uploads the videos. She commented on one of my one Little Nightmares video, and so I was watching her. And she didn't have a mic and video, and that's one of the reasons my mic is all the way over here. This is where my mic is. And she didn't have a visible mic. I don't like the visible mics anymore. I liked them for like a hot second, and now I'm kind of over them. And so I asked her, what mic do you have that's so far away from your mouth we can't see it? And she's like, I have a lavalier mic that I hide underneath my hair. I'm like, ooh, a lavalier mic. I had never thought to go that route. So I think I'm getting a lavalier mic. That's my next move, I think. Alright, so that's how I get out of this level, and I don't want to get out of the level yet. But yeah, I'm thinking lavalier might be what I'm doing next. I keep going back and forth on what the next right approach is. Right, because I've got the capture card now. I have a quote-unquote new webcam coming up soon. That's my Princess Leia hairdo. Kind of want to get a better solution for microphone situation. I just don't know what it is yet. I don't know if I want to go with a USB mic. I don't know if I want to go with a GoLX R. I don't know if I want to do a lavalier. Lavalier feels like... I feel like a lavalier would be the cheapest solution to get good sounding audio right away, right? Because I can put it right here. From your time in film school, you can tell you that audio is number one priority, 100%. But I feel like my audio is adequate, right? Like, I don't feel my audio is a negative thing. I mean, aside from y'all literally just telling me, turn down the game volume and turn yourself up. But yeah, I feel like if I had a lavalier mic, that would solve the audio problem, right? That would put, that'd make, you could hear me better, but at the same time, would it really, like, I want to be able to get to the point where I can have the sliders and I can move things around. I kind of want that GoLX R. I just go back and forth on what the right approach is for all these type of things. And I think that's one of the reasons why I don't play games like The Sims, right? I'm too much of a tinkerer for these type of things. Right? I was really hoping I'd get him. This, of course, is much longer than in the actual movie. See, this is why having Han Solo is so crucial. Because at this point, he can dodge. Although I just got shot and killed. Whereas some of these other people can't do that. So yeah, so I'm torn between the idea. Do I go with a lavalier mic, or do I try to go with like a shotgun microphone off of the GoXLR? Because I think I would enjoy having the GoXLR. I think I would really like having that as part of my setup. And so part of me is like, do I want to even spend the $30 to get the lavalier, knowing that that's not long-term solution planning? Right, why waste that $30? Because I've already wasted $30 here and there on stuff. Again, it's not a waste if you enjoy it. But like, for instance, I have a collateral bendy arm that my microphone's on. The idea being that I could bring the mic in and talk to it right up here, and then I could move it out of the way, and I just hated it. I didn't know I hated it as much as I did hate it, but I've learned I hated it. So now I have it behind the monitor, and that's what my microphone's on, and it's pointed directly at me. But again, if I had a shotgun mic pointed at me, that would be, I think, pretty good audio. Because this is only length of an arm away from me. Right? I can get a shotgun mic, attach that up to the GoXR, and that would work. The GoXR is what? GoXR is going to be $250 for the GoXR, right? And then shotgun mic is probably going to run me another $50 to $100. So I would say it's about $350 or so to be able to get that audio that I want, right? $250. I would guess. Geeky girl, please tell me, geeky. Please let me know if I feel like $100 for a shotgun microphone in XLR is the wrong price range. I'm lucky that, I work from home. This is where I sit 8 hours a day. So I've got nice monitors. I've got a big monitor that's, you know, this HD ratio and a normal 3:4:3. So this is a 16:9. This is 4:3. I keep wanting to replace my 4:3 with another 16:9. I don't have the room to go width-wise with it. But I would run it up and down, right? So I would run it as a vertical monitor as opposed to a horizontal monitor. But you can get cheap vertical 16:9s. But once you start twitching it to like a vertical monitor, you start getting a monitor arm. Or you're paying a lot more money for it. Old fat guy. Oh, aloha, my friend. Sent me the I'm going to bed text, which translates scan to bed in 10 minutes or sleep in the doghouse. I'll catch you another time. Aloha. It's always an honor to have you here, my friend. It's always an honor to have you here. I'm probably getting close to it's going to bedtime for myself. What's with these lights that seemed into me? Fade set. There. Fade is much nicer. What do you think? One more level? I think one more level would be good. What are my stats? How am I doing in the game so far? Just want to know how long I've been streaming for. I'm sure I can write uptime. That would do something for me. Yeah, let's do one more. We'll do one more level. I feel like I've paused a lot. Rescue the princess. So yeah, so I think the next move for me is the Go LXR and the shotgun mode. Not the full one, right? I kind of like the idea of the full one. I just think, I don't know if I would really use those other things, the difference between the mini and the full one. It's $150. I don't know if I would use the sampler and the voice changer. Whereas I know that if I had $150 just lying around, buying, you know, the 16 panel or 32 panel, whatever the maximum size of the Stream Deck, that would be a better investment of my money. Good night, Sam.
Hi, Geeky Girl.
She prefers to go by Geeky, by the way.
Geeky. Oh, and hi, the one Wolf. Oh,
yep, you can call him Wolf.
Wolf. Okay, God, I did not know about these weird nicknames.
Yes. And can you
did anybody redeem more points?
Yes, Old Fat Guy has redeemed some more points towards the Ready Player Two challenge. I don't know. It just tells me how much they've donated overall. Please close the door on the way out on your way to bed. I mean, I'm not going to say I'm going to be done with the things on my stream at that point, but I just feel like at that point, from a technology standpoint, I have the things that I feel like I would need to do to feel like I'm a real streamer at that point. Oh, Geek Girls contributed four more points for that. You know, Geeky Girl, I'm gonna honor you. I'm gonna go get you a gator head. Hold on. We gotta put on the Be Right Back, of course. Again, once I have that Stream Deck, I'm just gonna be able to click
Dad
that.
Dad will be right back. Dad will be right back. He might use the bathroom. He might get a snack. He might move Audrey. He might move Sam to his bedroom. He might move Maggie. He might go to get a snack or a drink in 5 minutes. He might be right back in 1 minute or 2 minutes. 3 minutes. 4 minutes. 5 minutes. 6 minutes. 7 minutes. 8 minutes. 5 minutes. 10 minutes. Or an hour. If you see a streamer's name pop up in the chat, he might come to raid someone.
He might just come to go home. He might just come to go to the bathroom also and pee. Don't say he needs to go poop.
And he was ready for the grand finale and the other chap. He's gonna be right back. Dad will be right back.
Dad will be right back.
He might use the bathroom.
He might get a snack.
He might move Audrey.
He might move Sam to his bedroom.
He might move Maggie.
He might go to get a snack or a drink in 5 minutes.
He might be right back in 1 minute or
2 minutes.
All right, here you go, geeky girl, because I respect what you're doing. I'm going to give it to you anywhere. No, worth it. You want a little nightmares? All right, I'll do it on little nightmares. Oh. You're the best for donating to Ready Player 2. Oh, I don't know how I'm going to play Little Nightmares with that. I'm saying that right now. You might actually make the points back up by then. Well, we'll see. I always can refund the points. Where'd my glasses go? Okay, cool. Resume. I left the door open. I yelled at Sam to close the door and I left it open myself. See, I just thought it was so fascinating, this idea that this girl is having people watch her play video games, and it's not like she's making highlight videos. They clearly are, like, her playing the whole level, but she's only doing it via YouTube, right? There isn't, like, any interaction. Very bold. Very bold strategy. Because at first I thought maybe she's a YouTube video game streamer, right? Because if I wasn't affiliate and I hadn't signed that agreement and I knew what I knew now, I wouldn't sign that agreement to be affiliate. I would stream on both YouTube and Twitch at this point. That's what I would do. But Twitch forces you to sign exclusivity with them when you sign that affiliate contract, which again, I get, I understand. And I think one of the reasons why I would make that knowing what I know now is because I do know that some people are like savagely efficient with getting subs and stuff and getting all the other quote unquote monetization going on, and I'm just not that person. Partially because, one, I don't really want it. Right? It sounds weird. I prefer ad revenue, right? Like, I prefer just to get the money from you guys watching my ads than to get money from subs. I greatly appreciate everyone who does subs. But, so yeah, I have no idea when or if I'm ever going to see that fabulous first Twitch payout check. I don't know when that's going to be happening. I have no idea when that's going to happen. And I think because I have no idea when that's going to happen, I just question what's the... What have I really given up exclusivity for? But I think everyone has that, like, that those, like, stars in their eyes. I can make money doing this. Let's sign it. If I could use Twitch as an income over school breaks, I'd be sick. Yeah, no, I agree. And honestly, between the two of us, you have a better chance of that than I do, honestly. I think you've built a much stronger community. Right? I feel that it's just... Yeah, I haven't done that. So yeah, I just thought that was so interesting, the idea that she would stream to YouTube, but not live. And she's got, like, all of, like, the overlays, and she's got, like, an intro song and an outro song. It's just so fascinating to me. I think because I've never seen anyone do it. And I always find those type of things fascinating, when someone's doing something that no one else that I'm aware of is doing that. Let's use that as a proper statement. I'm sure she's not the only person in the world filming herself playing video games and then uploading it to YouTube. I'm sure there are other people who do it. Yeah, I do appreciate the trying things out for the sake of trying things. I go, the last couple days, I was talking to someone who I knew was an obvious catfish. It was painfully obvious it's a catfish. And it just got to the point where I'm like, okay, I need to know why you're pretending to be something you're not. And what is your end game from talking to me with? And it was awkward. And then, you know, finally, I ended up just blocking them all on social media. And of course, like, right about the time that person popped into, quote-unquote, popped into my life, another person also popped into my life, and they didn't talk to me very much at all, but today they started texting me a lot more on Instagram. And again, I'm not saying that they're the same person, but it's part of me wondering, like, is this the same person? Do they just have multiple catfish profiles? Being very suspicious. What is their motivation? Lone Wolf has redeemed Chug 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 Chug. Oof. You're in luck. I got a good amount here, too. To the dude who used to chug beers at the end of the man show. One, because I'm not drinking beer. And two, that dude, I mean, he just, it looked like he would just open his throat and all the contents of the thing would just pour down in the, if you know what I'm talking about. I don't know how old you are, Wolf. And I don't think Geeky is old enough or the right demographic to really be into the man show. Someone maybe chug a whiskey on stream once. Oh yes, someone did make you do that. I don't know who that is. Probably someone who is incredibly good at their points. Come on. Is that my one shot to get in there? Oh, you're 23. Yeah, so I don't know if... You may even be younger than the Man Show was, but the Man Show was a show on Comedy Central with Jimmy Kimmel and Adam Carolla. That was kind of their first big break, I would say. That was the show that really kind of launched the two of them. And every show ended with a guy who is, I think he's a Chicago person, or at least Wisconsin, that upper Midwest thing. And he would go ziggy zaggy, ziggy zaggy, oi, 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 ziggy zaggy, ziggy zaggy, oi, oi, oi. And then he had two beer steins. And he would literally these two beer steins go, and the whole contents would just slide down his throat. Yeah, it was incredible. 1999 is when it was here. So yeah, so you were not older than the Man Show. You're not younger than the Man Show's better statement. But, yeah, that was, man, that was the right time for me to be really into that show. I think if the Man Show was on the air now, I wouldn't watch it. I'm not saying that I'm a more mature, sophisticated gentleman than I was back then. I'm just saying, I don't know if I would watch it. When I think about the shows that I liked back then, that I'm, you know, the type of media that I watch and consume, it's just changed dramatically, and I think that happens with everyone. You know, there's things that you watch when you're younger that you get into, and there's things that you're like, ugh, I can't believe I was into it. I mean, not to totally cringe, but at one point, I did have subscriptions to Maxim, Stuff, and FHM. All three, the holy trinity of being a douche dude in the late 90s, early 2000s. Oi, oi, oi. Geeky knows what's up. Again, probably not the right demographic, but I'm not surprised you at least know the reference. Geeky. This game is a lot of fun. It really is. I'm not saying that the first one wasn't cute. I'm just saying this one, they managed to do all of the fun stuff that made LEGO Star Wars the video game fun, but they put it in a world that more people like. For better or for worse, more people like the original trilogy than the prequel trilogy. Yeah, I don't know if I'd watch The Man Show. I probably would watch an episode of two of them now, but it would be from a nostalgia standpoint. Watching The Red Green Show. What's The Red Green Show? I feel bad they don't know it because I feel like you watched it instead. Man, and I can change if I have to, I guess. Man, I've never heard of this. One, good for him for saying that. You should start shooting people. Studs too. Much later. Yeah, I've never heard of this show, this Red Green Show. I feel bad. I feel bad that I've never seen it. There's just some show that you just don't watch for whatever reason. Like we've been trying to watch Key and Peele, I think. Here's how the net describes it. Imagine the Canadian version of Home Improvement at Canadian-born comedian Steve Smith. And Colin by his not-so-handyman alias Red Green, and you have the series a sitcom sketch comedy hybrid. It's in the fictional town of Possum Lake, Canada. Follows the mishaps of Red, the leader of Possum Lodge Men's Club, as nephew Harold in the plight to be good handyman. Sounds interesting. Is it on any streaming media? Like, could I find this on Netflix? Could I find this on Hulu? Could I find this on God Say Amazon Prime? Oh, I needed the hat. Sorry, my bad. I get my helmet. Now I can go over here and activate it. Because I'll give it a try. I'll give it a try for you, Geeky. If you're like, yep, yeah, here's the show, here's how you watch it. I'd give it an episode. You're worth at least 30 minutes of my time that of something I enjoy. I think it's only on Roku. Well, Roku isn't a service, it is more of a device, to my knowledge. Right? I didn't know that Roku did their own programming, their own streaming service. There better be something pretty sweet in there. It looks like it's on YouTube. I'll watch on YouTube. I keep debating if I want to spend like the $16 or whatever it is to get YouTube without the credit, without the commercials. My big concern about it is twofold. One, I don't watch that much YouTube. And two, how will the content creators get their cut of the pie, right? My understanding is they take all of the money from YouTube Red or wherever it is and then divide it up based upon how big you are as a channel. So bigger channels are going to get bigger cuts in the pie. So content creators I do or do not watch may not get the amount of money from YouTube that they would get if I just watched their stuff with ads. And I'm not sure, right, like, ever since I realized that content creators get their income from me watching the ads, again, revolutionary concept, I can't believe I figured that out on my own, I've made a conscious effort to watch the advertisements. I want those people to get the money for their hard work. There are exceptions, of course, right, there's some that I'm not gonna the thing, right? Like, and now this, I'm not gonna watch. I'm not gonna watch the ad on it now. This, Comedy Central, maybe. Traditional media is maybe, right? But like, it depends on what the ad is and how many they're gonna ask me to watch, right? A 15-second ad, like a 2-minute video on the Daily Show. Okay, you got me. I'll give you that money, Trevor Noah. But if it's like, watch this 4-minute video for this 30-second ad. And NBC. Not NBC, I'm good. As they say, Mr. Garrison would say, you go to hell and you go to hell and you die. They send the pilot episode in Discord chat. Excellent. I will check that out. I will check that out for you, Geeky. I hope I enjoy it too, because there really is nothing worse than when like a friend recommends you watch something and then you watch and like, this is god awful. Do I really want to evaluate the friendship? I don't think I would, but you know. Like, there's only one show I always recommend to people, and that's, again, because it's, one, it's never not, like, when I convince people to watch it, one, it's a hard sell for some reason. I don't know why it is a hard sell. But everyone who's watched it is thankful that I've sold them on watching it. And it is the show Spaced, which, again, Geeky, I wholeheartedly recommend you watch. Aloha, Sage 2020X. You gotta get going soon. Sorry, I've been searching the streams a lot. I might not hear what you have to say. Sorry. No worries, my friend. Thank you for popping in for a little bit. I greatly appreciate all of my lurkers who are late at night. So I don't know if you're still, if it's still considered lurker. Lurker dinner? I don't know. We'll have to figure out what that should be called. But we'll figure it out together. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna shoot a bunch of shots down there. Eventually they're just gonna die. So yeah, Space. If you like the movie Shaun of the Dead, if you like the movie Hot Fuzz, I'm not even gonna say if you like the movie At the World's End, because no one saw that movie. But it was a good movie, I enjoyed it. I think it's a fitting end to the Coronado trilogy. Those guys, Simon Pegg, Nick Frost, and why can't I think of the director, Edgar Wright. That was the show that helped kind of launch them in Britain. There was actually a woman, Jessica Hines, who was a part of that, and she was actually more influential in its creation than Nick Frost was. She didn't make the transition to the big screen with those guys, but she was very influential in the creation of Spaced. And it's just such a good show, and it really does encapsulate what that time period of British pop culture was. So I highly recommend it to anyone. Because, again, it's a show about basically kids and... Is it seriously up here again? Any more points. That movie had to get to go to some cool in a different place. Let's go save the princess. She's gotta be kind of annoyed with us. We could have saved her and we didn't. I don't know if this is even the end of the level. I think there's more. At least in the complete saga, there's more after this. Like, what happens after this is another level. Okay, this is part of it. Cool. So, I had a lot of fun tonight. I hope y'all had a lot of fun, too. Obviously, LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy, will take longer to play through than the original LEGO Star Wars video game. But, you know, it is a classic. It is a lot of fun to play. And I hope you've been enjoying being here as much as I've enjoyed being here for you. I want to thank everyone who participated today, whether or not you were a mod like Geeky or you are just a lurker like Sage. Definitely want to give shout-outs to other people who are in the chat who showed up. Par with the Silent Jeep or just Para, good friend. Jorgen64PC, new follower, was here for a period of time and did a lot of discussion about LEGO, so I'm very excited about this friendship that me and you are going to have. And that's about it. Oh, Lone Wolf? Wolfie? As I'm going to call you, Wolfie? Wolfie Wolferson? Yeah, who should we raid? Let's see who we got to raid. Oh, look at that, I'm 10% to give my way through the game. So based upon this, it's going to take 10 weeks to beat this game. 10 weeks. I'm up for it. Are you up for it? Oh, wow. We got Viva La Llama doing some mental health chatting. That feels like it's the winner right now. Because, I mean, Jolly Llama's there, too. I don't know who the third person is in this chatting. Mahler is there. Viva La Walnut. Evan Commander is also out. Kidding is talk. That's always fun. I enjoy her stream. We just raided Azelrak, so we're not going to raid her again. We can open up a poll and we can vote. Yeah. Yeah. Let's do that. Thank you so much for donating, Sage, to the Ready Player 2 Challenge. Sam, is greatly appreciated. Let's do a poll. Let's see if we can remember how to do a poll. I hear it's easier if you do it through the Twitch page. Let's do that. Dashboard. Stream Manager. I want to make a poll. Well, I should just use this view. I don't know why I'm even trying to use OBS. Edit stats and panels. Mod actions. Just type poll. Well, that's good to know. Alright. Poll. Start a new prediction. Open setup menu to create a poll. I have to do a setup menu? Have I never done? I don't think I've ever done a poll before. Yeah, so I type poll. And then channel management. Yeah, nothing happens. It wants me to type. Hang in there. We're loading your activity. Oh, here it is. I got activity. Who should we raid? I'm going to throw a couple of people at you. We're going to throw out Nerdy and out Dorsey. His title is Sucking Things in 3D First Playthrough. He's kind of a retro gamer. I met him when he was restoring some old Game Boys. Seemed like a good dude. We're going to throw out there. Viva La Walnut. I think that's it. I think there's only people who I'm going to throw into the poll. I mean, Viva just feels like the right person. I'm going to throw Lando Lakes out there just because it's good to have three. She's also doing a podcast. Or maybe, no, that's a rerun. We're not watching that. Screw reruns. Duration 1 minute of the poll. Ready? So you guys better be ready to vote. Let's go. I do like this view better. I'm gonna have to remember to use this as opposed to trying to use OBS. Get rid of all these docks. These docks do nothing for me. Looks like everyone wants to raid Viva La Walnut. I have three votes and only two viewers. I'm not trying to be Donald Trump here and say that this is rigged, but I do feel like it's pretty obvious. I'm just going to start typing raid to save ourselves the embarrassment of it going to be 3-0 for Viva La Walnut. Raid Viva La Walnut. Right, and it's kind of tough because she's got like a couple people chatting. I just don't feel like I know. Well, I do know Jolly Llama, and I met Mahler. But yeah, we're gonna raid Viva La Walnut. I'm assuming everyone in here knows Viva. Honestly, I think I know that Geeky knows Viva. I feel like Lone Wolf knows Viva. Please, if you don't know Viva, let me know so that I can like tell you who she is. She's awesome. She's a Canadian streamer, variety streamer, just all around positive person. I love her to death. No, let's get out of that one. No, I'm gonna load her up on this. Where's there? I haven't heard of either option before today. Oh, well. She's a sweetheart. She's really one of the most positive people there are. Gotta get past this stupid, what's this ad for? Eat more chicken. Chick-fil-A, gotta get past that. So again, thank you so much everyone for participating. This has been a lot of fun. Let's raid Viva La Walnut. No raid call, just say aloha, she'll know who I am.
Viva La Walnut. Viva La Walnut. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm done. You got what he's But you have to be wearing pink or of some kind. I'm wearing enough pink for both of us. Dad, are you wearing pink?
Ask me if I told you.
You have lights that can be pink, though. That counts. At least shine. I'll look at that. Star Wars is always fun. Do you want to come and sing for a little bit? You want to come sing, Crimson? Y'all are welcome. That's okay. I appreciate him saying hello. Sounds like Lego is fun, at least. Lego Star Wars? Nice.